In a crowded field of 20 candidates, Joe Biden has broken away from the pack. He's at 39% of potential Democratic voters. They say he is their top choice for the nomination. Vermont Senator Bernie Sanders way back in second with 15%.
Biden getting a bigger bounce than expected after entering the race last week. Today, Biden begins campaigning in Iowa, where he is already doing much better this time around than during his previous runs. The Iowa caucuses are 279 days away, so joining us now is CNN political director David Chalian to break down our new numbers. David, this is a bigger bounce, as we're saying, than expected.
Yeah, it is a big bounce indeed, and we should note this is the first poll that we've seen conducted entirely after Joe Biden rolled out that video last Thursday, Allison. And there is the horse race, as you said. Joe Biden way out in front. 39% of Democrats are backing him, 15% for Sanders. And you see the next four, Warren, Buttigieg, O'Rourke, and Harris, all sort of grouped together in that next tier. Let's look at where they were last month in our poll compared to now. And look at that Biden movement. That's 11 points higher than he was just a month ago. This clearly is a bounce out of his rollout, out of his announcement. The only other candidate to make a big jump, Buttigieg, went from 1% to 7%. But you see Warren holds steady. O'Rourke and Harris go from double digits to single digits. Even Bernie Sanders went down a bit, all to the benefit of Biden and a bit to Buttigieg. Here is one thing I want to sort of caveat, just so folks are aware, where the support is coming from. Look at this. Among white Democrats versus non-white Democrats, Joe Biden's commanding lead is being fueled by this huge lead among non-white voters. He's at 50% compared to Sanders at 14. He's still leading among white voters, but not by that huge margin that he is among non-white voters. Here's the thing. Nobody is locked in yet here. Nearly two-thirds of Democrats might change their mind, according to this poll. 64%, 36% say they definitely are going to support the candidate they are with right now. We also asked about the kinds of qualities of a candidate that people are looking for. There it is, guys. Electability, the chance to beat Donald Trump, is the most important candidate quality. 46% call it extremely important. That's followed by the right experience, will work across party lines, looks like the future of the party, and then far less important credentials than the candidates. How about the issues? Take a look at this number. Climate change. 82% of Democrats call it extremely important. This is an animating issue inside the Democratic primary, followed by Medicare for all, then guns. Some of the other topics you've seen debated: free public college, impeaching the president, paying reparations, voting rights for felons, they fall far below. But climate change and Medicare for all, those are the animating issues inside this Democratic nomination race.
All right, John. David Chalian, do not go anywhere. We need to talk much more about this poll, the breaking news, in just a moment. First, though, this morning, Joe Biden makes his first trip to Iowa as an official 2020 candidate for president. This comes the day after the former vice president took on President Trump at his first official campaign rally in Pittsburgh. CNN's Jeff Zeleny on the ground in Iowa with Cedar Rapids. Jeff, what can we expect today?
Well, John, good morning. Joe Biden has come to Iowa so many times as a presidential candidate, but never like this, as a front runner. Of course, his dreams to be president were twice extinguished here in Iowa by those Iowa caucuses in 1988 and in 2008. But he argues this is a different time and a different moment, as he presents himself as the best Democrat to beat Donald Trump.
Good. Joe Biden's coming back to Iowa, hoping the third time is a charm in his quest to win the presidency.
The major moral obligation of our time is to restore, rebuild, and respect the backbone of America.
He's opening a two-day visit to Iowa after firing up supporters in Pittsburgh on Monday with a message to middle-class workers at the first rally of his new campaign.
If I'm going to be able to beat Donald Trump in 2020, it's going to happen here. It's going to happen here.
The battle lines are quickly coming into focus, with Bernie Sanders urging voters to take a closer look at Biden's record by firing off one of the sharpest exchanges yet to a Democratic rival.
I helped lead the fight against NAFTA. He voted for NAFTA. I helped lead the fight against PNCR with China. He voted for it. I strongly oppose the Trans-Pacific Partnership. He supported it.
Those stark policy disagreements will be litigated first in Iowa, the opening stop of the Democratic nominating contest next year. Biden collected the first endorsement of a major union, the International Association of Firefighters, whose leader warned the party from choosing a liberal nominee.
This may not be popular in parts of the Democratic Party, but we have to have a nominee and can't have a nominee that is too far left. It's just that simple.
This didn't sit well with President Trump, who blasted union leaders vowing that their members, quote, love Trump. Long labeled a frontrunner before entering the race, Biden is now trying to justify it by keeping his sights trained on Trump as long as he can.
Donald Trump is the only president who's decided not to represent the whole country. The president has his base. We need a president who works for all Americans.
Yet Biden is also still trying to strike the right chord in reconciling his long record in the Senate. While declining to directly apologize last week to Anita Hill for her treatment during the 1991 Clarence Thomas confirmation hearings,
I am sorry she was treated the way she was treated.
Taking a different tone Monday during an interview with ABC's Robin Roberts, with his wife Jill by his side.
As the committee chairman, I take responsibility that she did not get treated well. I take responsibility for that.
So Biden saying for the first time he takes responsibility. Notice that change in language there from just a couple days ago. But John and Allison, that is part of his record that he's bringing here to Iowa. But notice the contrast Bernie Sanders was drawing directly with Joe Biden's voting record. That is what voters here, of course, will have to decide between Joe Biden, Bernie Sanders, or all of the other candidates. John and Allison.
Jeff, stick with us. We want to bring back David Shallion to talk about all of this. It sounds like we can put the Anita Hill stuff to rest now. It took a couple of decades, but he got it right there. And it doesn't sound, David, as though that's what voters are focused on. What you're seeing in the new polls that are out 6 minutes ago is that it's electability. It's who can beat President Trump.
That's certainly, of all the candidate qualities we tested, that is what is top of mind, where most Democrats say that's most important to them, Allison. And it's interesting hearing in Jeff's piece there highlighting Sanders going at Biden on his record and where they differ, because one of the things we see in this poll is that there's a whole swath of Democrats who are not familiar with Joe Biden's record way back then in the Senate. So there is a potential opportunity for his opponents, like Sanders was doing on Anderson last night, to try and educate a newer part of the Democratic electorate about Joe Biden's record.
I will say that Joe Biden's getting some help from an unlikely source over the last 2 days, and I think that's President Trump. Joe Biden is basing his candidacy on, I'm the guy who can beat Trump. He is taking on the president directly. And what's the president doing? He's responding and egging him on. I'm not going to read these tweets, but the president tweeting repeatedly here. And to an extent, Jeff, it seems like he's making this a two-man contest, which is exactly what Joe Biden wants.
John, there's no question about it, and that is what some of the president's advisors had hoped he would not do, to try and elevate someone. Now, it's difficult to elevate Joe Biden because, of course, he's the frontrunner, the former vice president. But this is exactly what the Biden team was hoping would happen, and, in fact, it has happened. It's one of the rare times that a Democrat has been able to draw President Trump into something. Usually it's the other way around, that President Trump is drawing other people in. So this is a fascinating dynamic to watch. We do know the president is watching all of this unfold. We also know he's a little bit concerned about the attention that he's not getting. Of course, every time Joe Biden is on television, others are on television, the president not getting that airtime and oxygen, if you will. But by talking directly about the union members yesterday, for example, the president going after the union members themselves and the union leaders saying their dues are too high, it's clear Joe Biden is in the president's head, no doubt about it. He's treated him sort of differently than all the other Democratic candidates. So we'll see how that, keeps playing out here. But there's no question Joe Biden benefits from all of this because it goes directly at his argument that he is the best Democrat to take on President Trump.
Yeah, and David, Joe Biden is seizing upon this. I mean, you know, in his campaign launch video,
right,
he talked about the difference that he sees in America than what the vision that President Trump has had. And so yesterday, again, in Pittsburgh, he talked about the difference. So listen to this.
Everybody knows who Donald Trump is. And I believe and hope they know who we are. We have to let them know who we are. We Democrats and we independents who have the same view have to choose hope over fear, unity over division, and maybe most importantly, truth over lies.